Alrighty, time for round one. My opponent's name is F6ing, which I think that's great. Let's go ahead and play first. One lander. Oh, with a veteran motorist. If I was gonna draw, I might consider keeping this, but I think I'm gonna go ahead and mulligan. This hand is fine, though. Alrighty, we'll keep planes. Yeah, I'm gonna put planes on the bottom. The thing is, yes, I would like to hit my third land drop, but I really want a mountain, and if I put planes on top and then draw another planes, that ends up like being somewhat disastrous. Well, let's see if I get punished here. I'm gonna play the Renegade, because I'm not really that close to getting Revolt, so I'd rather just have the 2-2 in play. And the thing is, I also have an extra turn or two, so to draw a land, so I drew the land there, so it's all good. Let's go mobile garrison. I kind of want to set up a turn where Solemn Recruit gets in there, or gets a Revolt. Alright. Mountain would be pretty nice. Because then I'd be to do something. Alright, let's just play the Recruit then, I guess. Crew with attack and tap that. Whack. Alright, so Mountain would be a pretty great draw, because I could get to crew the mobile garrison with the Wheelsmith, tapping down, or making a creature unable to block, untapping the Wheelsmith, and then making another creature untapping, or unable to block. And that would be great. Prey upon. Ah, there goes my Solemn Recruit. That's alright. And if my opponent attacks, I probably will block the Blade Master. I think that's a fine trade here. Though I'm actually happy they didn't attack, because I still have this Renegade Wheelsmith in hand, and that's going to make it so a bunch of their blockers don't matter. Let's get the Mobile Garrison in there. Attack. Alright, and play Restoration Specialist. The reason I'm not playing the Aviary mechanic is that if I draw another land, I can bounce and replay Countless Gears Renegade and get a token out of it, and the 2-2 is just not going to attack past Blade Master anyway, so I might as well just keep sending with this mobile garrison here. Opponent on blue-green stuff. What you got? Alright, well, it certainly can't block. I can double block the Blade Master, but feels like that goes wrong pretty easily. And if I draw lands to play Wheelsmith and Aeronauts, I'll be pretty happy. Red card is not what I want. Lifecraft Cavalry is... I guess I have to just play Aviary Mechanic, because I'm just like to the point where I think I'm going to be doing some blocking here. I think I just have to... And also, because my opponent attacked with Blade Master, then played a Revolt card, decent chance they were just setting up the attack with Blade Master and then playing this as a 6-6, so if it trades off. So they might not actually have a combat trick. And I'm at this point probably going to try to double block Lifecraft Cavalry if it attacks, since I can't just keep taking damage here. And because these cards in hand give me a pretty good long game. I might actually be at the point where if I play, draw Mountain, I go like Reckless Racer, discard Wheelsmith, draw cards to try to hit a fifth land, but we'll see what my opponent does here. Another Prey Upon, huh? Alright, I guess my Restoration Specialist is dead. That's fine. What next? Another Prey Upon. Alright, well, now I'll probably crew here. I suppose I should have crewed the first time, but it actually worked out better because I played around the second Prey Upon. See? It was smart. Kind of got there. It was intentional, I swear. So now does my opponent even have good attacks? They just, like, don't. They can attack with just the Blade Master. I mean, the Plunder is getting in no matter what, but they could attack with Blade Master and offer the trade for the Mobile Garrison, I suppose. But attacking with Lifecraft Cavalry. Oh, interesting. Well, I'm blocking there. Do I want to trade for... I don't really want to take six. All right, I'll just do these blocks. I want to have a Aether Meltdown also. If they have a trick, then things are going to work out very poorly for me. But I cannot. I'll select for inspection. Sure. That saves their blade master, I suppose, but I'm actually fine taking down the Lifecraft cavalry here. Then they get to play Skyship Plunder. All right. Well, see what we got. Mountain. That's where we wanted to start. And I guess I'll play Reckless Racer. And either one could have blocked the Blade Master, I suppose, but. Ugh. Ridge Scale Tusker? All right. Well, I guess I'm dead. Yeah, that card's nonsense. It is pure and utter nonsense. Yeah. All right. Well, that was unfortunate. I like Alley Evasions against Prey Upon, so I'm going to keep that. I don't really want Conviction still, I don't think. All right, I think we're good. Would like to play first. Another one lander. Meh. All right. I mean, this is a keepable hand. Probably just going to get Prey Upon'd. But I have Alley Evasion, so that is a thing. This time I will keep Plains on top. In fact, I will not keep Mountain on top since that does not help cast my Solemn Recruit. And I have no double red cards in my deck. Plains does. Okay. So I do get to play turn 3 Solemn Recruit. And my opponent's not going to get to prey upon it on turn 3, which is nice. And then I get to have Caught in the Brights and Alley Evasion up. And at some point I can go Wisp Weaver, Flicker, Recruit, and get counters. So all this works out quite nicely. Let's just Caught in the Brights that thing. And then attack for four. I want to save Alley Evasion. I could have used Alley Evasion when they block, because they would have blocked, I assume. But I would much rather save that for a Prey Upon. Yeah. And because even if I didn't Caught in the Brights that thing, it would have eventually they would have found a creature that they could use for, with Prey Upon. And then I would be able to save it and keep attacking, which is nice. I guess I should attack first in case they have Select for Inspection. And Reckless Racer. Reckless Racer, when you've Mulligan and have a 6-drop in hand, isn't great because I don't want to discard Wisp Weaver, but I also don't really want to discard lands, so I'm not sure what I'm supposed to be discarding here. High Tide Hermit, probably with a Prey Upon as the follow-up, is my guess. My opponent has some nice energy cards here. Yeah, there's the Prey Upon. All right. Caught in the Brights, land. Hit for two. I don't want to loot away land or Wisp Weaver. I think just playing a 4/4 flyer is just going to be good this game, even if I don't have any combos with it. If I get to the point where I get to Wisp Weaver and play Rishkar, Pima Renegade. Okay. Then maybe I will be able to start looting after that. Though I need to draw a vehicle now before I can start using Reckless Racer. I guess I'm getting attacked. No, not getting attacked. All right. Play a 3/1 flyer, I suppose. Opponent can sack Widow Weaver's Puzzle Knot. I don't know what they're going to do with all this energy, though. They have lots of energy here. What's my best draw? Honestly, probably like Renegade Freighter or Iron Tread Crusher or some just stupid vehicle because I have Aeronaut Admiral in play. Eddie Trail Hawk's not bad, actually. It's down to like not a whole lot, and then this lets me start attacking with Reckless Racer. So now, if I draw a weak spell next turn, I can just loot it away with Reckless Racer and maybe get to play Wisp Weaver Angel, Flickering Eddie Trail Hawk. It also just puts my opponent on a very fast flying clock. So I like that. Opponent probably starts attacking with Rishkar here, right? And the Druid. Yeah, I'm gonna take it. I could block Druid of the Cow with Reckless Racer, but I don't really want to walk into a combat trick. All right, land is nice. So now I get to not use Reckless Racer, but I get to Eddie Trail Hawk the Reckless Racer. Hit my opponent for six, put them to seven. And play Wisp Weaver and Flicker Eddy Trail Hawk. Yeah, I'll use that ability. And then now my opponent's not very close to killing me with the forces they have in play. And I have a lot of good flyers. Like, even if they have Prey Upon to kill Wisp Weaver Angel off, like, High Tide Hermit, I guess they get to then attack for 9. And I'm 1 point short. Interesting. Or I could throw away Eddy Trail Hawk, take 6, going to 9. I'm just going to take it. All right, Countless Gears Renegade. Interesting. In this case, I'm going to attack and then play the Countless Gears Renegade as a blocker. And now I can double chump and go to 2. And if they have a pump spell, I guess I do die. And if they don't, my Aeronaut Admiral kills them. And if they had Prey Upon, presumably they would have killed me. Alright. No select for inspection either. Nice. Alright. Game 3, huh? Kind of wish I had another Alley Evasion, but I do not. Unfortunately, Precise Strike doesn't save you from Prey Upon very well. Gear per Osprey does not seem particularly great. All right, I think we're good. Maybe try not to mulligan this game? Do we mulligan this? We're on the draw now. And we have a mount. We have a lot more planes in our deck. Or not a lot more. I guess only one more. Whatever. I'm keeping this hand. We are doing it. This hand is just so good, because if I draw planes, I can motorist into more lands. And if I draw another mountain, I can still play Aether Chaser, and then buys me time to draw a third land. Long Tusk Cub, huh? I think I'm going to play Veteran Motorist here. Put that on the bottom, put Mountain on top. And the reason is, if I play Aether Chaser, yes, that keeps the Cub back, but if I play Motorist, even if they can generate energy, I still get to trade for the Cub. Alright, I'm happy trading for a very dangerous card. And Renegade Freighter. I think we're going to run over our opponent. Note, they did miss a land drop last turn. They must have kept some greedy hand. let's go Reckless Racer. And then I could have played Mechanic plus Aether Chaser, but I'm going to play Racer and then discard Weld. Oh, I meant to discard Weld Fast Martyr. Alright, well, this play didn't work out quite as well because I really wanted to discard World Fast Martyr to try to hit lands to play Iron Tread Crusher. What can you do? Though, actually, do I want to play Iron Tread Crusher here? I guess given the... yeah, that's fine. Let's Renegade Freighter first. It kind of doesn't matter at this point. My opponent's just not playing anything, so they're just going to get destroyed. I don't even, like, even though I sequenced these last two turns in a fairly medium way, it, like, again, just like, pretty irrelevant, I think. Next turn, I'm going to get to... yeah, that's not going to do it. All right, land. Solemn Recruit, Aether Chaser. Crusher. Freighter. Discarding Mountain. Opponent chumps and goes to 5, and I have like 20 million things out. And there we have it, I suspect. My opponent's going to need something pretty great to get out of this one. But when you mulligan, keeping a long tusk cub seems like it makes sense. Wildest Dreams. Yeah, that will not quite do it.